My name's Stan Riddle. I'm the technical training supervisor for Acoem USA, and I've been doing precision alignment of machinery for about 42 years.
My name's Eric McKeefer. I've done shaft alignment just a handful of times. Today I'm using the AT100. It is a laser shaft alignment system that pairs with the horizontal shaft alignment app.
This little contest we're going to do, just to be honest and upright and straightforward with everybody, I roughed in alignment on both of these machines. And they are, as far as I could tell with a straight edge, the same. I roughed them in vertically and horizontally. We minimized the soft foot. We tightened the bolts down in a controlled, repeatable pattern. Same thing we always do in our alignment training classes we teach. So these two alignment demonstrators should be just about exact clones of each other. So the only variable is going to be if the old grizzled guy with the dial indicators can do this as quickly as the young man using the AT100.
Laser heads are connected.
And I'm mounting up my brackets. You know, one of the challenges, I guess, with shaft alignment using dial indicators is it does take a little time to get indicator brackets together, get good travel on them and all those things. So it is one of the drawbacks, but they're still very accurate measuring tools. So we'll see how it goes.
Okay, I got my angle set. Taking in dimensions. Taking first measurement. Second measurement.
While he's taking measurements, I have to keep up with direction of rotation of these indicators to make sure they're going positive or negative. Make sure they don't roll around to the midpoint, and I think it's positive, but it's really negative, so it is a little bit slower. And now that I've taken my three measurements, I have to calculate the 6 o'clock measurement using a validity rule.
Grabbing my shims for a vertical adjustment.
I have just set my indicators at half travel, so these are really going to be measuring live as well. So I can calculate the shim values pretty much in my head, or I could graph it out. Now they should be fairly close vertical, so I'm going to roll around to horizontal. And I can use the jacking bolts to make this final correction, hopefully.
First correction complete. Remeasure.
That went worse than I thought.
Second measurement.
And my challenge is when I move one set of jacking bolts, it changes all the indicator numbers. So I just have to kind of sneak up on it, do it a little at a time to make sure I don't overshoot. Make it worse instead of better.
Vertical is still slightly off.
Now I'm starting to remember why I like lasers. I still got some movement, so I'm gonna have to do this again. Oh, let me check out one more time. Don't get too fast, Eric. Make an old man look bad.
I'm doing my hopefully final measurement now.
I'm gonna make some new circles. I'm running out of marks. Minus 16, yes. Sweep back over here. Plus, plus.
plus.
All green. Done.
I'm as good with dials as anybody. I don't claim to be the best, but I'm as good as anybody I know with using dial indicators to do shaft alignment. And I did a good alignment. I'm staying on zeros all the way around in 49 minutes. Not bad. If you use dial indicators for shaft alignment using a reverse dial indicator process, you got to admit to yourself, that's pretty good most of the time. Eric, however, using a much better tool, more accurate tool, faster tool, easier tool to use, knocked out a good alignment in 16 minutes.
Yeah, compared to other shaft alignment tools I've used, I felt this one was really accessible for someone who didn't have experience. Using the AT100 was pretty simple and easy. I caught a snag after my first measurement and adjustments, but then the app told me exactly what I needed to do, just change out a couple of the shims. I think maybe when tightening down, I had over-tightened or something. And after redoing that measurement with the new shims in there, and even double-checking it after that, I got all green checks.
So it's kind of like I'm driving a 62 Plymouth and he's driving a Lamborghini. It really doesn't compare. It is not apples to apples. But it does show you this. Eric, with little to no shaft alignment experience, but using a far superior tool, is much faster, much more accurate, much more repeatable, and doesn't have to run into the same problems I do taking analog measurements with an indicator as opposed to taking pretty high-tech, precise digital measurements with the AT100.